माशाल्लाह माशाल्लाह। तो
स्टूडेंट्स द इंस्ट्रक्शंस वर सेम दैट डू नॉट ओपन द कैमरा डू नॉट राइट और स्पीक एनीथिंग इन उर्दू एंड थर्ड एंड द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट अगेन आई एम सेइंग प्लीज इमीडिएटली टर्न ऑफ योर माइक आफ्टर asking me the question. Okay, is it clear to everyone?
Yes,
yes,
sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, okay, mashallah. So this is your mathematics class, is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so students, listen this thing that today's class is very important. Okay, there are because new things I have to discuss today. So please quiet and listen it carefully. Is it clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Just revise your exercise. If you have any query, please ask me 5.2. I am giving you 2 minutes. Just go through 5.2.
If you have
any query, please ask. And remember, today I will start noting your name. If any, I found anyone. Open the mic after the question, after asking something he didn't or she didn't turn off the mic, then I will today definitely note the name, okay, because you are not following the instructions.
Sir, I want to ask something.
Okay, yes, beta, please.
Sir, exercise 5.3, question number 1, 6th part and 7th part.
Beta, is I am giving any assignment from exercise 5.3? Just tell me this thing first. One by one. Please, Mantasha, you go ahead. Isma, mute yourself. Yes, Mantasha?
Yes, sir.
Beta, I did, can I give it in assignment this exercise?
Sir, by mistake, I said okay. I'm saying exercise.
Sir, I have one query.
Okay.
Seven.
Listen, I am explaining.
Sir, sixth part.
Okay,
I have exercise 5.
Sixth part of
exercise 5.2.
Listen, okay, quiet everyone, mute everyone. I am explaining this whole exercise, so you should quiet, okay, and turn off your mic. Is it clear?
Okay, sir. Okay,
sir.
Yes,
sir.
Okay.
Assalamualaikum, sir.
Assalamualaikum, sir.
Sir, page number?
67. I am discussing the exercise.
67, sir?
Yes, yes.
Okay, sir. Thanks.
Okay. Now, everyone, I don't want, when I ask you, when I want you to give you an answer, then only that time you will open your mic. Okay. And I am discussing the exercise. Okay. In the first question, which of the following are like pairs and unlike pairs? Okay, there are so many fractions are given in mixed form and in fraction form as it is. Okay, or we can say that in improper or proper form. Okay, so listen this thing. What you have to do that in this, you have to find which one is pair, which pair of the fractions are like and unlike. So you know that like fractions are those fractions having different denominators. Okay. Like fractions and unlike fractions. You have to do. Okay. So just tell me this question is, you can do this question. Exercise 5.2, question number 1, whole part. Okay. Just
yes, sir.
On the basis of denominators, Okay, you tell me like and unlike. Everyone can do?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now I am moving to question number 2. Okay. In question number... Yes, beta. In question number 2, what we have to tell proper fraction. Okay. What is the definition of proper fraction? Proper fraction is those fraction whose numerator is less than the denominator. Okay. Means numerator is less than denominator. Okay. Is it clear? Question number 2 also to everyone. Just you have to see whose numerator is less than the denominator. And it gives you proper fraction. Is it clear? Yes, students, is it clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Only one student says.
Yes, sir, it is clear to me.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir, it is clear to me also.
Okay. Yes, turn off your mic. Please remember this thing. If I found today any student do not follow my instructions, then I note the name. As I am noting the name also, but I didn't give to anyone. But from today, if I see anyone, then I will give it. Okay. Now come to question number 3. Again, in question number 3, what you have to do? Which of the following are improper fractions? So you have to see improper fraction. Okay. So you have to select improper fraction. So what is the definition of improper fraction? A fraction whose numerator is greater than denominator. Okay. Numerator is greater than denominator. Okay. Very good. So you have to just see numerator and denominator for improper, proper, like, unlike. Okay. Is it clear now? Moving to question number 4. Okay, in question number 4, convert the following improper fractions into mixed. So I am taking 1/13/5. This I have to convert.
Sir, I can tell.
This I am converted into mixed.
Sir, I can tell this.
Beta, wait. Everyone mute. Okay. You are not following, beta. Quite. Okay, what is the procedure? You have to divide. Okay, 5 2s are 10. Okay, 3 comes. So I am saying that this thing will become your whole number. Okay, and what is the remainder? It comes here, and your denominator, which you have already. Okay, the denominator which you have already will remain same as it is. Okay.
Sir, I'm having query in question number one.
Yes, beta, tell me.
Sir, I also.
Just tell me, what's the query?
Question number one.
Yes, beta, tell me. Which part? In question number sir, one. Listen.
Sir, I'm not understanding only question number one. Okay, so you beta. Can take part 3.
Okay, beta. I'm not solving it. I'm just explaining. You can tell me. Okay. In this question one, you have to, which of the following fractions are like and unlike? Okay, there are pair of fractions are given in each part and you have to select which of them are like fractions and which of them are unlike fractions. So you have to check the definition for like fractions. The definition for like fraction is beta given on page number 64, which says that a fraction having same denominator are called like fractions. Okay. So you have to see first part is your like fraction because its denominator are same.
Sir?
Yes.
Sir, can you explain again because your voice would not keep clear?
Okay, listen carefully. Okay.
Sir, your voice is low.
Wait.
Not audible.
Wait, I'm telling it again.
Voice is very low.
For I am telling in question number 1, there are one pair of fractions are given. Okay, means two fractions are given in each part. What you have to do, you have to select which part is a like fraction and which part is unlike fraction.
Sir, okay, I understood. Like part one is like fraction because the denominator are same.
Very good, mashallah. So I am telling you. Yes, beta. I am telling you question number 4. So first part I completed on my screen. Okay, is it clear? You can also check whether we do it correct or not. So what is the way of doing?
Yes, sir. Everything is clear. Alhamdulillah.
What is the method of doing? You just multiply these two things, and you add this thing. Then you will 5 × 2 + 3. So 5 × 2 = 10 + 3. It will be 30, and denominator will remain same. So beta, this thing and this thing are same. So we can say that we do it correctly. Is it clear, beta, to everyone?
Yes, sir.
MashaAllah.
Sir, question number 4 is, I understood question number 3.
Yes, I am telling you.
Following our improper fraction.
Okay, beta, first of all, turn off your mic. Okay, you are not following, but then it is forcefully I have to write your name. Okay. So I am telling you again, improper fraction, question number 3, what you have to do? You have to tell which of the following are improper. Again, whenever this type of questions ask improper, proper, like and like, what you have to do? Just you have to remember the definition. If you remember the definition easily and correctly, okay, then you will answer it. In this question number 3, improper fraction, okay. Improper. So what is improper fraction? Go to again 64 page number and definition is written. Whose numerator is greater than denominator? Numerator is greater than denominator. Okay, beta. Just see whose numerator is greater than denominator. Okay.
Proper fraction
are easy. Now, moving to question number 5. Yesterday, I checked very few students submitted me this assignment. Okay, beta. So please do your work on time so that.
Sir, I have submitted.
I am saying, beta. I listen. What I am saying, just listen it, beta. I am saying very few students submitted. So in few students, you already come.
Yes, I will submit it because one exercise I was not understanding, so I will.
Okay, beta. So question number 5, beta. Convert the following mixed fraction. Just I previous question convert mixed fraction into what? Into improper. So what we have to do, let's say 8, 3/5, you multiply this 8 × 3 + 8 × 5 + 3, so it's 43/5. Okay, is it clear
now? Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, now yes, this question is very important. Okay, so please listen it carefully. Okay. In 6th question, what is given here is write fraction equivalent to 3/5. Okay. So 3/5 with denominator 20. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So what's the rule for equivalent? Rule for equivalent. The rule is that, listen. The rule for for making any fraction equivalent is that you have to multiply by same non-zero number. This rule is given on page number 67. Okay. Means that you have to multiply with a number which is any number.
That but it's not very easy. Before I was not understanding, but I understood it.
Sir, by its denominator.
बेटा लिसन, बाय मल्टीप्लाइंग न्यूमरेटर एंड डिनोमिनेटर विद द सेम नंबर, बट रिमेंबर इट शुड नॉट बी अ जीरो. ओके, इन दिस व्हाट यू हैव टू डू, यू हैव टू मेक डिनोमिनेटर, यू मेक दिस फ्रैक्शन इक्विवेलेंट बाय मेकिंग डिनोमिनेटर 20. सो व्हाट यू हैव टू डू, what we have to do, we have to make denominator 20. So what we want to multiply here to get 20 in the denominator, we multiply it by 4.
So,
numerator also we have to multiply with the same number.
12.
Okay, so sir, this 12. So this fraction 12. Is very good. So this fraction is very equivalent.
Sir, I'm not understanding.
Okay, beta. I'm
sir, telling. Sir, I have done it by some different way.
Okay, you show me then. You WhatsApp me after the class. Then I tell you. Okay, I am saying, beta. Okay, if you okay, have sir. To get, if you have to make a fraction equivalent, what you have to do, and listen to me carefully, then you will be able to understand it, inshallah. Then just do two ways. You have two ways. Either you have to multiply numerator and denominator, or you have to divide numerator and denominator. Okay, multiplication always easy as compared to division, but you should know both the methods. So in this, whenever this question comes to write the equivalent, you have to multiply numerator and denominator with any number. But remember two rules, again two things. The number you are multiplying with numerator and denominator should be same. Should be same, and
sir, I understood. Like 3/5 with denominator, it is saying so 5 4s are 20. And so denominator we are multiplying from 4, so we will multiply from 3 also 4.
Okay, very good. But remember this thing, that you have to multiply with the same number. This is the only rule. Multiply with the same okay, number, sir. Numerator, yes, denominator, sir. And it should not be zero. Okay, beta.
Yes. Sir, please tell me question number 7.
Okay, I am telling you question number 7. Write 4 fractions equivalent to each of the following. Okay, you have to write 4 fractions. Here it is given 5.7.
So,
what you have to do? You have to multiply with any number. Let's say, first you multiply 3/3. Then again we take it, we multiply it with 4/4. And take this number, we multiply it, 7/7. So what we are doing, as per rule, we are multiplying numerator and denominator with the same number. Okay. Is it clear, beta?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, very good. So there are so many numbers, infinite numbers. Oh, beta, mute yourself. Who is this? Should I record the
question name? 8.
I am coming to it. I am telling it to you. Okay, question number 8.
Sir, by mistake.
Okay, beta, turn off your mic. 2 mics are open. Faiz and Aman Jamal. I just write the names. Faiz, I write the name. I am writing the name. Okay. Yes, question number 8. Write 5 equivalent fractions. As it is, I do it question number 7. Okay. So in question number 8, what you have to do, you have to make equivalent fractions and you have to write only 5. Okay. So it is given 12 upon.
Sir, you can tell again.
Okay, I am telling it. Okay, beta. In question number 8, what we have to do? Write 5 equivalent fractions for 12/36. Okay. So what you have to do? 12/36.
Sir, can you explain again question number 6?
6, beta.
Yes, sir.
Okay, beta. Beta.
So please explain this first, then that.
Yes, sir.
Question number 8. I am telling you first. Okay, beta. I have to complete the next topic also. So
yes, sir.
For query, you can WhatsApp me on my number. Okay, now question number 8. Okay, you have to write 12 upon 36. Means this is your final answer, and you have to write such fractions which is equivalent to 12 upon 36. Okay, so how you will make, suppose that you have to make 12 upon 36 as your answer. So let's say you have to take let's say any number, let's say 3 upon 6 upon 8. Okay, let's say 6 upon 8. So what you have to do, you have to made 6 and it's multiplied by 2 both sides. Okay, so for the Rubik, yes, two right, two names I have written. Okay, one is Faiz, and again it is Faiz. Okay, and you are not following Faiz. Your name is written again.
Two sir, times. I want to ask you why you have written here 6 upon 8.
Beta, listen to me. I am writing 6 upon 18. Okay, because when we multiply 8 by 2, we will didn't get equivalent, because 8 to the 16. Okay, and in the question, it is given that we have to make the denominator 36. So we have to take such a number that by multiplying the same number in numerator and denominator, okay, it will become 12 upon 36.
Sir, we can do this in lowest term.
In lowest term.
Yes, sir. Sir, that, sir, listen, we have written sir 12 upon 36. Sir, listen, we can do, sir. Like
listen, 12, listen, sir. listen. First thing, for equivalent fractions, there is no limit. You can do, you can write infinitely equivalent numbers. Only just.
And I cannot understand sixth one question. Write the fraction equivalent to.
Beta, this question number 8. Let me tell you again. You have to make equivalent means. Who is made writing on the screen again and again after telling so many instructions? 12 upon 36. This answer we have to bring, this answer. So by what fraction, suppose that 2 upon 2. Okay. What we have to multiply here to get 12? What we have to multiply to get 12?
6.
6.
2 multiply by 6.
And here it is?
18.
18.
Yes, sir. 18. 18. Yes, sir. 18.
You can,
6 upon 18.
You can easily do this. Take any number which is same in the numerator and denominator and divide it by 12 and 36. If you will get the, if it is totally divisible, your remainder will come zero.
Then what is, sir, you can tell again.
Okay. I am
not explaining. Your voice is coming so breaking much and voice is not clear.
Okay, beta, I am telling you again. You have, in this question, you have to make equivalent fraction. So apply the rule of equivalent fraction, take any number and multiply the numerator and denominator with the same number. Okay. If you get 12 upon 36, then that fraction is equivalent to 12 upon 36. Is it clear?
Yes, sir. Clear.
Okay. Yes, sir. Yes, okay. So in the question.
Yes, sir. It is clear.
If you having any problem, beta, please WhatsApp me after the class. Okay, I will reply you, inshallah. Okay. Whatever you are having problems in mathematics, you can text me on WhatsApp. I will reply you, inshallah. Okay. So.
Sir, on your personal number.
On my personal number. Okay, because there are so many questions. Yes, so move to question number 9. In question number 6 to 9, only same methods apply, just writing the equivalent numbers. Okay. Check whether the fractions are equivalent. See, you have to check whether they are equivalent or not. If you multiply 3 upon 7 into such a number that it will give 15 upon 37, 35, sorry, then it will be a equivalent. Let's say if you multiply 3 by 5, okay. If we multiply 3 by 5, it's 3, sorry, is 3 upon 7. If we multiply it by 5, and here also equivalent. Remember this thing, if it is not the same number, then you are not writing equivalent fraction. It will come you 15 upon 35. Is it clear?
Yes, so, sir.
First part is equivalent. Okay. Okay. For second part, what is this? What is given? Yes, who is Faiz? You are not following my instructions. This is your third time. Okay. I write your name thrice today. Okay. Three times. I will take some action for you. Okay. I will tell to the school that you are not following my instructions. Fourth one is four upon seven. So when you multiply by
two,
you get 12 two. Upon 14. For equivalent, you have to multiply three. With the same number, three, for this three. So this will you get two. 12, but this will you will not get 14. So this is not equivalent. Is it clear?
Yes, sir. There will be 21.
Yes, yes sir. So it is not equivalent. Yes, so coming to yes, the sir. Today's topic. What is the, we have to write simplest form of a fraction, 5.7. Okay. Simplest or irreducible. Fraction. Irreducible form of a fraction. Okay, so listen it carefully. Okay, for writing simplest form of a fraction, there are two methods. Okay, two methods. One is prime factorization. And second topic is HCF method. Okay, so what we have to do in prime factorization method? In prime factorization method, let's say as 48 upon 112. Okay, what we are doing here? Beta, who is this? Who is this? So 48 upon 112, what we have to do first, what is the rule of prime factorization? Express the numerator and denominator of a fraction as a product of its prime factors. So we have to do factors of 48. So it is 2 with 2 to the 4, 2 4 is the 8, 2 2 1 the 2, 2 2 the 4, 2 6. Again, who is this? Again with 2, it is 3 and 3. So 48 will be your 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3. This is your prime factorization of 48. And similarly, for 112, you do it prime factorization 2 5s are 10, 1 carry, 2 6s are 12. Okay. 2 2s are 4, 1 carry. 2 8 is 16. Then again 2 times 2 under 2, 2 4 is 8, 2 7 and 7 into 1. Okay, so your factors will be 48 can be written as 2 into 2. Yes, beta. Yes, yes, please. So you can write 48 is equal as a prime factorization in numerator part, and write 112 as prime factorization in the denominator part. Okay, then what you will see, you will cut the common thing. Okay, and whatever is left in the numerator and denominator, it then it is the your required fraction. Is it clear? Again, I am saying that the
yes, sir, it's clear.
again I am saying, listen it, mute yourself, I'm listening. The method from prime factorization is that whatever the number is given in numerator and denominator, just do its fraction, just do its factor it, just do factorization of the numerator part and denominator part. And as it is, you write a fraction, write down the factorization of the numerator and denominator in fraction form. Then what you do, you do cancel out the common things. What the number is left on the numerator and denominator gives you your answer. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir. It is second method for HCF. You know the method of HCF. Okay. Finding the HCF on the numerator part. Okay. And denominator part. You can do it separately. You can find out the factors of numerator part and second part. Whatever the HCF come, okay, whatever be the common, then that will be your HCF. Then divide the numerator and denominator with the given HCF. I am telling you the giving you some example. Okay, let's say giving you one example. Yes. It's HCF of 200, let's say 276 upon 115.
So sir, due to network problem, it is disconnecting.
Your side, beta, what happened?
Sir, due to network problem. My side is disconnecting.
Okay, beta. So please try to sit at such a place there where networks come totally 100% networks come. Okay. I find out the HCF of 276.
Sir, your voice is not audible.
It's not audible.
Sir,
okay.
Why is it not audible?
Beta, most of the students saying that it is audible. Please take see your connections. This is connection comes fully
sir,
or not?
Audible.
Listen. Beta, time is. Beta, time is running. Listen to me. For what you have to do, you have to factorize this thing, okay? And for 115, for the denominator part, you factorize this thing, okay? Then, factors of 276 will be 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 23, okay? And factors of 115 comes to be 5 into 23. So this thing is common. So you divide the numerator and denominator by 23. Okay. Then what you will get? You will get your answer as 12.
Common.
Yes, as it is 12 upon 5. But such type of questions will be asked in the test. So please make your concept clear. Okay. If you are having any type of problem, please ask me. Okay. On my number. So, okay. Now.
Okay, sir.
Next topic is very easy. Okay. Just you have to compare the fractions. Okay. You have to compare the fractions.
Means, fraction.
Sir, I have one little query.
Yes, beta.
Sir, can we do any, like, if you have to do any question in a prime factorization method?
Beta, this is up to you. This, I am telling you, na, this is your choice. There are two methods. Either of the methods you can adopt.
Sir, no, sir.
Yes.
I am saying that HCF method is hard for me and prime factorization method is easy.
Beta,
so
beta,
I can use that.
Beta, this I am saying that you have two choices. You can take any one.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Now comparing fractions. This is very important. Let's say take any fractions. It is first 4 upon 5 and 3 upon 5. You have to tell which is greater. Which fraction is greater? Which fraction is greater or smaller? Okay. So what you have to do when you see if two fractions with same denominator are given, okay, then the one fraction with greater numerator is greater among the two. Okay, Is it clear? If two fractions with the same denominator, rule number 1 on page 69. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Rule 1. Okay. If two fractions with the same denominators are given, then how can you check whether which fraction is greater and which fraction is smaller? Just go and see the numerator. The fraction with greater numerator is greater. Okay. So here,
yes, sir.
Here what is given? Whose numerator is greater? 4 is greater.
Sir, of 4 by 5.
So 4. Okay, so 4 upon 5 is greater than 3 upon 5. Okay, beta?
Yes, sir.
And for again, rule yes. is, and if two fractions are given and they are still having the same numerator, in the first I am seeing the same denominator, now I am seeing the same numerator. Okay, and
sir, then we have to check numerator.
Then we have to check the one with smaller denominator. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then we have to check one with smaller denominator is greater among the two. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, beta, now if you have three fractions, okay, and you have to check it again, okay. So what you have to do, just open to page number, 670. There is written to compare two or more fractions. Okay. Okay, for that, you have what you have to do. Yes, beta. To compare
two or more. Sir,
beta,
no query, sir.
Ek second. Yes, sir. Hold. 1 second, beta. Let me see whose mic is open. Yes.
Sir, it's okay. No queries. It's okay, sir.
Okay. So, beta, listen this thing carefully. If you have to check, two or more fractions are given to you and you have to check which one is greater.
So your voice is not coming now.
Okay, wait for a second, beta. Open page number 70 and see if two or more fractions are given to you. Okay, so what you have to do, you have to check whether which one is greater and which one is smaller. Okay, then we find that what is the way of finding that we have to take the LCM of the denominators. Okay. We have to take, there are different ways of comparing the fractions. Okay. First, it is given that you have to do prime factorization or you have to do SCF method. There's another method. Just we have to find LCM of the denominators only. Okay. We take the denominators and second, and listen, second is we make the denominators of each fraction equal to the LCM to convert the fractions into like yes, fractions. Sir. Okay. Then compare the numerator of fraction. So this is the way I am seeing.
Sir, your screen is not working.
Yes, beta.
Your screen is not working.
Okay, wait.
Wait, yes, beta. Sir, your screen is blank.
What happened to my pen? Let me check once again.
Yes, sir, it is blank.
Let me check once again. I am giving you some examples.
Yes, sir, it is blank.
Wait for a second. Let me check. Wait. Please see example number 2. Let me check. Okay. See example number 2 on page 70.